What is up, beautiful people of YouTube? My name is Yurtastic, and welcome to a very special episode today, part of the GTA 5 mods tips and tricks that I'm trying to give you guys here. And today we are going to be focusing on how to install custom airplanes in GTA 5, or how to install airplanes in general in GTA 5. If you come to GTA 5 mods website, you come on the vehicles, aircraft, there's plenty of them. I'm going to download and install this 787 Boeing Dreamliner because I'm doing a video on it. So I said, you know what? Let me show people how to do this. Now, it's very simple if you're doing it from Skyline GTR Freak. So far, 9 out of 10 airplanes that I have downloaded and installed have been from this fella right here. And most likely the airplanes that you will see on GTA 5 mods is going to be from him. He's amazing. He does a great job. And the nice thing about him is he includes a very detailed readme. But the reason why I'm doing this video, because some of you guys are not so much of readers as much as you are visual learners. So this is for the visual learners out there that want to know how it's done. Now, obviously, I've installed or I've downloaded it, and here it is. Let's go ahead and just put it like this. So I've installed and downloaded it, and here it is. In this pack right here. Now, obviously, his readme, I opened it, and here it is right here. So for this, you would need OpenIV. If you don't know what OpenIV is, basically a software that allows you to go in the deep in the directory or the registry, if you will, for GTA 5 and GTA 4 as well. But we're talking about GTA 5 today. So after you downloaded it, extracted it, now you have here. Now you come to the readme files. This is just the features. And here the instruction says, place the 787-8 folder into game folder update X64 DLC pack. So basically what he means is place this folder in this path. Now we're going to go follow the path. So he says, go to update. Now, in my case, I'm going to put it under the mods. You might have the mods folder. You might not. If you don't, that's fine. But it's basically the same thing. So you go on the mods, update. Then you go X64, then DLC pack. So that's what he's saying to do, basically. Very simple. If you have OpenIV, you already know you need to click the edit mode. If you don't or you're new to it, then you need to click the edit mode. And he's saying, go ahead and install, drop that in. So the first step is done. All right, so here it is. I just had to refresh it. So here's a 787 pack, okay? So that's the first step. All right, now we've done the first step. Now the second step he wants you to do is go back to OpenIV. I closed it accidentally. So we're gonna go back to OpenIV. He wants you to basically go through the second step. Now, all three steps are very important. Very important. So he wants you to go to, again, I'm going through mods. He wants you to go update the RPF. The step we're doing, I highlighted it here. He wants you to common, data, DLC list, which is going to be here. Now, if you go here and sometimes for me, just copying and pasting it doesn't work. Okay? Let's go ahead to edit mode to show you what I'm talking about. I'm gonna go edit mode, boom. Okay. So sometimes copying and pasting that doesn't really work for me. So what I end up having to do, see, it doesn't really work for me. Now, what I end up having to do is extract it to the desktop. So right click on the DLC list, extract it to the desktop. Okay, so here we are at the desktop. And now we'll go to the desktop. Should be there. There it is. Now it's gonna come up with options what you want to open it with. I suggest you have Notepad++. To me, it's the easiest way to open it. You could have a different way, that's completely fine. So what we're gonna do here is basically copy paste this, get down one, paste that, and then he wants us to put this in there. Well, we could have just copied his really, but that's all right. Here, we'll just copy his for the sake of this tutorial. So we'll just copy paste it and go over this, and boom. Make sure everything is right here. We're gonna save that. Now remember, this is on our desktop. So what we need to do is go back here and drop it so it can replace it. Okay, so double check, make sure it's in there, go down there. There's a 787-8, all right? Now the last step in here is he wants us to go to the extra title update data.meta, which is saying this is in the same place, there it is. Now they gotta do the same thing, except the only difference here is this is .xml, this is .meta, or meta, whatever you want to call it, right? So what we're going to do is extract it, but the difference here, at least for me, I don't have any software right now that controls or that opens .meta files. So what I'm going to do is, now again, you could do the same thing, is change this to .xml, just for now, software. We're gonna open it up with Notepad++ again. We're gonna go to the bottom, copy paste what he has here, and we're just gonna put it right there. Boom. So there it is, a 787 is in there as well. Now before we put it back in, don't forget to change it back to .meta or meta, whatever it is. I'm sure somebody's gonna correct me in the comment section below. Now again, you might have a software that's gonna open that without having to change that. I don't, so that therefore that's how I did it. So now we're done here. So to recap, open that 787 folder and put it in this directory. After you open the 787 folder, you need to go over here to the location he's telling you to go to with Notepad. Oh, he even says Notepad++. Okay, sweet. So with Notepad++, you need to extract it to the desktop, remember, so you can open and add this line towards the end. Save it, bring it back to OpenIV. Once you do that, you go in the same location, extract that. I change it to .xml. Added this section, change it back to .meta, dropped it back in here. Now, when you go in the game, how you're gonna spawn this is you're gonna go by trainer. You're gonna go by trainer, and you're gonna spawn by 788, which I'll show you guys once we get in there. All right, guys, so here we are. I just came here to the Sandy Shores one just to test it out. And let's go ahead and, so we said we got a model spawn. Sorry, vehicle spawning, and you gotta go search for vehicles or spawn vehicles by model name. There it is. And he said it's 7888 or 88, and there it is. Just like that, nothing more, nothing less. The airplane is in there and it has been installed correctly. So that's basically what it is. So to recap the video, you'll need Notepad++ and OpenIV if you don't have it. You don't necessarily need the mods folder, but we do recommend the mods folder for it. If you don't have it, that's fine. Just follow the path that he told you it's in. After you follow the path, follow the three simple instructions, which is place the 7887 folder in the first path he told you. That's it. Then in the DLC list, add the line that he gave you. You're done there. Then the extra title update data, you add that couple lines that he gave you as well. But make sure you extract it to the desktop so this way you can add it. And what's nice about his airplanes, just to give you a brief, I'm not really trying to, you know, I don't really know him personally, but I'm not really trying to sell his vehicles for you. I mean, it's free anyways. It's not, you don't have to pay for it. But what's nice about them is they always come with like different liveries. So it's not just Air Canada. So you got the ANA Airlines, All Nippon Airlines, or All Nippon Airlines, I believe it's Japanese Airlines. You got Oman Air, you got American Airlines, you got Polish Airlines, Aeromexico, United, British Airways. So a lot of really, really nice ones. I might even go for the Aeromexico because it's a really nice one. So regardless, the glare is just based on my visual settings. It's not really anything to do with his airplane. Besides that, ladies and gentlemen, this is how you install airplanes in GTA 5 mods. This is how you install custom airplanes for GTA 5. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comment section below. Again, I really heavily advise you before asking any questions. I don't mind answering them, but I'll probably have already stated it in the video. So I really do advise you in checking out the video for more questions that you might have about it. But besides that, let me know. And if you enjoyed this video, or this video helped you, a like would be appreciated. And join the J Army, because I do a lot of, like, I'm planning on doing a video with this airplane right here. Oops, we're about to hit the tree. So I'm about to do a video with this airplane right here. So make sure you do join the J Army so you can watch videos like this. I already have two videos with an Airbus 321 Neo and a 787 Max before, obviously, it was, I mean, sorry, 737 Max before it was grounded. That I'll link in the cards in the end of the video here so you can watch them as well. All right, guys, my name is Yurtastic, and I am out.